Hi, my name's Matthew Jester, just making a quick video here. So I have a certificate of completion just showing that I'm competent and certified in the field of hypnosis, and then I'm going to go ahead and get started with my general introduction. So please watch my video, Hypnosis Abuse and Speech Inhibition. I will leave a link to watch the video in the description. I'll also leave additional links in the description of other relevant videos. I've been abused with hypnosis, and my ability to speak is being inhibited with hypnosis, which is why I have to read everything when I make videos. If you notice me stuttering, speaking slowly, being unable to speak clearly, or any other difficulty speaking, I explain in detail the specific methods and techniques that are being used to inhibit my ability to speak in my video, Hypnosis, Abuse, and Speech Inhibition. These issues speaking occur consistently in each of my videos, specifically within the first 3 minutes. The hypnosis inhibiting my ability to speak is often very noticeable throughout my videos, and I will leave a list of the various hypnotic commands that are specifically being used to inhibit my ability to speak that can be recognized in my body language, facial expressions, tone of voice, and speech patterns in the description. So, what I'm doing right now is I'm trying to just, write down what I need to say to describe the hypnotic seal that was placed on me. So, I'm going to go ahead and just start reading what I've written down. This video is going to explain a hypnotic seal that was placed on me and review some evidence of the seal sabotaging the hypnotic induction and being used to separate me from a hypnotherapist that was attempting to break the seal. The method used to separate me was making me lose trust with them, making me believe they were intentionally sabotaging my attempts to reverse the hypnosis and lying to me, and making me believe that what they were doing was deplorable. What I'm trying to explain is because the seal involved basically the belief that instilling the belief in me that based off of my attempts to help people and as well as things that could even result in saving children's lives, as a very specific example, and to believe that they were intentionally sabotaging that, which is absolutely deplorable if they were, right? And that's the point that I'm getting at, is that's enough to kind of cross the line, right? Feeling as if they've gone too far, if that makes sense. So that's what they used as a seal to prevent me from going back there for them to help me. So, I could even say by simultaneously believing, but I think what I'm trying to say, what they were doing was deplorable. Instilling the belief. Hold on just a second. Sorry about that, but I'm instilling the belief that they were simultaneously sabotaging my attempts I'm going to say intentionally. Sabotaging my attempts to. People. Which. I'm not sure if I even want to say something like specific along those lines. If I want to say like intentionally sabotaging my efforts. Which could potentially save innocent children's lives. Dying of cancer or malnourishment. And then I might even have to start the video out with explaining some things as well. Give me just a second. I'm gonna reword that. Or malnourishment. Hold on just a second. Wow, I'm really the hypnosis is really making this seem like much making this much more difficult than it normally would be under normal circumstances. So again, I apologize. Like re-racing, I mean air racing, can you even say it right? Erasing and rewriting the same thing, same word, like, I wrote the wrong letter just barely. I wrote an E instead of a C. Okay. It's a good thing that I left the word potentially in there as well. I would hate to accidentally send the wrong type of message, saying that I could do something I wouldn't be able to do, making a guarantee that I might not be able to guarantee. So, let's see. The video is going to explain a hypnotic seal that was placed on me and review some evidence of the seal sabotaging a hypnotic induction and being used to separate me from a hypnotherapist that was attempting to break the seal. The method used to separate me was making me lose trust with them, making me believe they were intentionally sabotaging my attempts to reverse the hypnosis and lying to me, and making me believe that what they were doing was deplorable by instilling the belief that they were intentionally sabotaging my efforts, which could potentially save some innocent children's lives who were dying of cancer or malnourishment. So there's this part, and then, there's more too I need to include in the video. The acupressure makes it pretty clear, and then there's that too.
Okay.
Still haven't even put in my earrings yet today, and I forgot to do that, so. I'm going to go ahead and get started with that here in just a moment. I'm going to finish here in just a moment. Hypnosis is inhibiting me a lot. Oh, that's right. I remember. I didn't even include something else. It would be nice to actually include this as well, too. Alright, so first of all, I mean, I could just briefly go over what, you know, just a brief summary of what exactly like I had in mind, right? And, anyways, okay, sorry, hypnosis. All right. So wait, I do need to have some clear here. I did want to include two pressure points using fingertips. And then also just at the beginning of that next sentence that I erased, the hypnotic seal utilized. Sigh. Change here, so which was a metaphor indirectly referencing, and instead of acupuncture because of the needles, I wanted to say acupuncture utilizing needles and euthanization, which is what they call, you know, putting the dog down. Acupuncture and euthanization. Utilizing needles. So they actually also, I wanted to point this out, the emphasis was put on the hypnosis being the barrier in between, like, being the obstacle preventing me from, you know, helping those children.